That reminds me, Caitlin and I were talking about Jim Ross one time with our friends, and it was like a swift kick in the face of how ridiculous we sounded, because one of our friends was like, "Do you guys know him?" So we're like talking about him, like everything is so right. Known on a true basis, because like we had a conversation with him. It was funny.
Yeah, that's Fanatics, man. Like,
yeah.
Oh, I.
We were talking about how his wife passed away, and we're like, you know, and like he's the kind of guy where I feel like he'll never marry again. Like he really loved her, and that's from listening to him on podcasts and talk about her, you know. But like that's what we were saying. Yeah. He's like, "Do you guys know him?" And we're like, "God, we sound like losers." No, we don't know him.
Yeah, you do sound like losers for sure.
Did it hit you right there or later?
No, right there, right there in the moment, Caitlin and I just started laughing because we're like, "Is that how we sound?" Because we are talking like we had a personal conversation with him.
Yeah, about most wrestling stuff. Uh-huh.
Well, I mean, again, our takes are taken from listening to the way he talks about her and stuff like that. So, yeah, we're making some assumptions here, but it's not completely unfounded. Yeah.
You guys are like the people in the Dave Matthews crowd that were in front of us at the last concert. Where they're like,
"Oh, he loves pickles."
They look back at each other and they're like, "Dave wrote this song when he was going through a bout of depression in 92. And you're just like, "What the fuck are you talking about, man?"
And then you realize it was you saying that.
Yeah, and then I wake up.
Because you're a super fan.
And I'm like, "God."
Yeah, you're like, you're holding a bomb.
Amanda did, when we were at the last Dave Matthews concert, we get there and we got there right as the first song was like in the middle of the first song. So we didn't miss much. And he was playing Fool in the Rain by Led Zeppelin.
Which God, you guys, really cool.
You guys were late. Yeah, we met some friends in the parking lot and they had a joint. And so we were like, I was like, "I should probably smoke a little bit." And then, I mean, we were 2 minutes late, if that. And so we got into the stands and we're standing there and we're sitting there for a minute and he finishes his song. And again, like I'd never heard Fool in the Rain by him, which was really cool to hear that. And just a different song that he didn't write. And he finishes. And of course he goes into like his, "Oh, thank y'all very much for being here, blah, blah, blah." And like, he goes on this like rant and he's like looking all over the place and like, you know, talking all weird. And Amanda turns to me and she's like, "Is he autistic?" And I was like, "Yeah, most definitely 100% he's autistic." Like, if you listen to him in any interview, in any talk, like 100 million% he is autistic. But that's why the music is so good. So, you know, sometimes you
get... that's what makes a real musical artist, is if they're autistic.
Yeah. It's like, you know,
it's a genre.
Add a little spice on top. Yeah. Yeah, if he took the test, he wouldn't even need to turn it in. They'd be like, "You're good. Matthews,
we saw you take it.
we heard you while you were taking it." Going that,
yeah. And all your answers are musical notes.
Shoot.
And who's that guy you drew on the top corner? He's like, "That's my new band member."
Okay, Bill Cosby there.
Yeah. Yeah, he didn't know he's also Bill Cosby.
Yeah.